Randy Stotts, Billy Ward now, and we couldn't have talked about the winning goal if you guys hadn't provided the tying goal. Billy, you scored it. I'll start with you. What was your view of that play, and what was initially the play called? Did you ever expect the ball to end up in your stick at the end?
It just kind of happened. You know, you just kind of react, and I saw Randy got the ball off the end line, and he started coming up, and, you know, I kind of started cutting through the middle, and my guy was behind me a little bit, and, you know, we made eye contact. I knew he was going to throw it to me. I didn't know how, and just lucky enough, I caught it, and it went in.
I'm sure, Randy, you've been hearing from everyone you've talked to that behind-the-back pass was spectacular and probably the best we've seen. But, you know, Canadian box lacrosse, I imagine that pass is just sort of the next day of the week for you.
I mean, yeah, I guess, like Billy said, I just kind of came around the crease there. And I had my head up the whole time. And all I seen was Billy's stick and Billy peeking up there. And I just tossed it in there. And it was a little high, but he caught it, so... He's good.
Is that one of those things you feel that double team coming? You got to think somebody's open.
Well, yeah, I seen the guy coming, and I just stood there. I waited for him to like come and get me, and he kind of tried to recover back to the middle of the Billy, and I got, luckily enough, while he was recovering, I got it to him.
Coach told me after the game last night, Billy, that he wanted to get you on the field. He's like, all right, who do we got to take off? But we got to have Billy out there. What's it been about you here in the last month that you specifically and this whole team is popping in these clutch goals?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it could have been a handful of guys that could have been out there. Lucky enough, it was me, and lucky enough, Randy found me. It's just a matter of staying calm, and I think I've been doing a good job of doing that, trying to stay calm and be the leader, you know, that the senior group has been the whole way through.
You end up in that crowd. I mean, you were surrounded. When the ball's coming in there, I mean, do you have any time to think, or is that just catch, react, and hope it goes in the back of the net?
No, I joke around. You know, I had my eyes open for the catch and closed my eyes for the shot, and yeah, lucky enough, it went in, and it's just all instincts at that point.
It was strange in the stadium at that point because the crowd, and I think the players too, reacted so much to the pass that nobody noticed right away that you had scored. Was that the same moment on the field?
Well, I thought I had missed. I heard a pipe and I thought it went out, and I was a little disappointed at first. The longest, about 2-3 seconds of my life. But yeah, lucky enough, I saw it trickle in and it all worked out.
All right, and so you guys tie the game up. There's 14.7 seconds left. Does, Randy, the thought go through your head, hey, we still got a chance to win this right now?
As soon as we scored that goal, I was like, there's 14 seconds left. I was like, oh, man, we have enough time to win the faceoff and come down and score another goal. And, you know, Daddy-O did a great job getting the ball to Pete, and Pete passed it to me. And I kind of froze and scanned the field there for a second. No one was open. I seen Kev pop out, and then I tossed it over to him, and Dylan snuck around his defense and like he always does, and found the back of the net there, and we went nuts.
It kind of felt like time stopped when you had the ball because you got it maybe with 10, 9 seconds left. And you're, wow, does he know how much time left? How aware were you of the time and really paying attention to all the specifics?
Well, I knew, like I said, I knew there was probably like 4 or 5 seconds gone from when Daddy won the faceoff and when I caught the pass. So there was probably like 8 seconds left. And my first thought was just to throw it at the net and hopefully someone would get in front of the net or something. And I just thought that, oh, I'll give it to Kev because that whole lane opened up on the back on the back side, and I thought he could run because he's a righty and he could run down the alley there and get a shot off. And Dylan's a smart player, and he does what he does, and he found the opening, and he buried the ball.
I imagine for you, Billy, no surprise that Dylan Donahue can score one in the last second there. You saw it against Yale last year, too.
Yeah, and I mean, we saw it against North Carolina, too. Mm-hmm. I think it was just a matter of time before they connected on a pass and finished it.
Now it's for the ACC title here tomorrow. You played Notre Dame, great game, one-goal game a month ago. How similar do you expect it to be to that game you played in the Dome?
Yeah, I mean, I think any game of this magnitude, you expect it to be kind of similar. I mean, we always have tough games against Notre Dame. It's always a high-intensity game, so I wouldn't expect anything less tomorrow.
And then, Randy, last thought for you. I mean, Notre Dame got a big win yesterday. What kind of game do you expect tomorrow, and how exciting would it be to win the ACC here this weekend?
Oh, man, it'd be really exciting. I think we're in for a big game tomorrow. You know, they're going to come out firing. We got to come out firing and be on our game. You know, we can't relax at all. It's going to be a good game tomorrow. It's going to be a tight one. So hopefully we come out on top.
All right, guys. Looking forward to it. Maybe save the dramatics tomorrow. Just a couple goal win, right?
Sounds great.
Thank you.